How much should thyroid ablation cost? Correct, Dr. Dhingra?
That is correct.
Let's ask those watching or listening, make the case for doing thyroid ablation in the hospital. And if it's done in the hospital, is the trade-off worth it? If it's going to cost more money, do you really get better results?
What I'm interested in is the facility fees, which is something which can substantially add to the cost of the procedure. And what facility fees means is where the procedure is being done.
Hello, everyone. Welcome. I'm Philip James from the Dr. Thyroid NRFAMD podcast. Today's guest is Dr. Dhingra. Dr. Dhingra, welcome.
Thank you, James.
Yeah, we have an interesting topic. For those listening or watching, we're not sending a direct, well-defined message in this interview necessarily. We're asking a question. How much should thyroid ablation cost? Correct, Dr. Dhingra?
That is correct, yes.
And there's some variables, right? Mm-hmm. So there's the probe cost. Then there's a critical thing to consider, whether this procedure is conducted in an office setting or in a hospital setting.
Yes. So I think the if you look at the cost of doing the procedure, it is obvious to anybody that when you compare the cost of doing an ablation procedure versus doing a surgical resection like a thyroid lobectomy, there's going to be a huge amount of savings from the point of view of anesthesia, the drugs, the operating room time, and so on, and instrumentation. Now, when you compare that with the ablation procedure, the biggest item, cost item in the ablation procedure is the probe. And the probe costs are more or less kind of consistent. They vary from country to country based on what kind of a deal the companies have with the countries that they are selling the product in. Within the United States, the costs are going to be more or less similar. So the biggest ticket item is immovable. That's the cost of the probe. What I'm interested in is the facility fees, which is something which can substantially add to the cost of the procedure. And what facility fees means is where the procedure is being done. It's not usually in an operating room setting, but it could be in a interventional radiology suite or another procedure suite within the institution. And what that does is add an expense called the facility fee, which can be substantial. And in fact, it can be much, we know from the experience with the other procedures that we do in the office, that can be an expense that it could be even higher than the facility fees. So I think there's a real savings if one were to do the procedures in a facility which is not affiliated and not within the walls of an institution, because then there can be a substantial amount of savings there. But before that, we also need to answer the question of whether the doing the procedure in an office setting out of the big facility, is it safe to do that, and is it a viable option? And that's been my interest, and that's what I'm looking at in our data. Mm-hmm. And it'd be interesting to see what the experience is for other people who are listening to or watching this show, how they feel about whether we should have some sort of restriction as to where the procedure can be performed. But I think the beauty of the radio frequency ablation or other ablation procedures is that you can do it in the comfort of an office setting where you have a less intimidating, more welcoming environment, which is more informal. It's like when patients come to have a needle biopsy in the office, that kind of a setting. So
yeah, so the question I guess I have as I'm listening to this is a patient. My first question is, would general anesthesia be used in the office?
Oh, no, not at all. That's the, I think the minute you bring general anesthesia into the equation, you automatically end up in the operating room, right? So you are either in an ambulatory surgery center or in...
And I think if we were to survey any doctor listening or watching who's performing thyroid ablation, I don't know if the split would be 50-50 of those who perform ablation under general anesthesia for the patient and those that do not.
Well, in my experience, I've not done any procedures under general anesthesia, which truly, I believe, defeats the purpose to a large extent. Of course, there are a number of advantages of ablation versus a lobectomy, but this is one of the major advantages. And when patient asks me as to what it's going to be like, I tell them that it's going to be like when they came for their biopsy. The biopsy took 10 minutes. This will take maybe 60 to 90 minutes, and depending on the extent of ablation. And most patients tell me that they are, because of the amount of local anesthesia used and the time that we take doing the procedure, most of them say that the experience was equal to, if not better than, when they came for a biopsy. So it's very, very well tolerated.
And then they don't get drowsy or what have you. So these are all good points, I think, for discussion. And I think the answers will vary widely around the world. But I think the topic of discussion that you bring up today, which is what should the cost be and should the procedure occur in the clinic or the office or in the hospital? And if it's done in the hospital, is the trade-off worth it? If it's going to cost more money, do you really get better results?
Yeah, so the either better results or you feel that it is unsafe to do it out of the office, out of the institution setting. My experience and my impression is that it is safe to do it outside the institution. It is... hopefully less expensive, although I would be interested in knowing other people's experience. I think that's what is desirable, that we have general acceptance that the procedure can safely be done in an office setting. Yeah. In my previous discussion with you, I brought up the need for ultrasound training, and people being good with the ultrasound intervention is the key to performing this procedure safely.
Yeah, and you know, maybe that's at the heart of all this. And listen, ablation, we hear stories now, it's not perfect. And a lot of times it's not perfect because the skill of the provider is not that skilled at ultrasound, and then they have problems. I think that's where most of the problems are surfacing from. So if we assume, and those patients listening or watching, number one thing they should be concerned about is the skill of their provider in regard to ultrasound. And if you, we know your last interview, you're so committed to ultrasound and being professional. That's one area you're very skilled, amongst other. You're a surgeon. But let's assume the ultrasound skill level is high. With your experience now, you've performed a number of ablations, thyroid ablations. If you were to write the guidelines today, where would the procedure take place? Hospital or the office?
If I were to write the guidelines, definitely the office. Like I said, that's one of the main attractions of doing the procedure. When you compare it with a surgical excision, and I don't see how it is any more unsafe to do it in a in an office community setting than, you know, you are with probably within 5 miles of patient's home. They can, you know, they drive in there, they do the procedure, they drive back, they're comfortable. It's just the desirable.
Hey, I'll tell you what, as a patient, I hate hospitals. You know, I feel more comfortable going to a nice clinic. Mm-hmm. I just do not like walking into a hospital environment. So yeah. On that note, why don't we leave it there? Let's ask those watching or listening, make the case for doing thyroid ablation in the hospital.
Yeah.
Right? We know where you stand.
That's right. I'll be so interested in knowing what other people feel about it. And if you ever got to write guidelines, make sure that we have, you know, the facility where the procedure is done is not a limiting factor, because that'll take away from the
sure.
purpose of doing the RFA.
Dr. Dhingra, a valid topic. We're curious to hear how people respond, what their experience is, what their feedback is. But as you know, thyroid ablation has been in the U.S. for a relatively short period of time, about 4 years, mm-hmm. and it's being adopted rapidly. Some of that is good, some is not good, based on the skill of the provider. But I think things are still sorting out. And this is probably a key topic that also should be sorted out.
Good. Thank you. Thank you for your time.
Dr. Dhingra, thank you for bringing up this topic of discussion. Have a great day.
You too.